The world feels like it's spinning in chaos. It's enough to make you want to hide in a bunker. Well, doomsday prepper Tim Ralston tells us how not to just survive, but thrive if disaster strikes.
Well, it's human nature. The strongest survive.
Tim is a world-renowned survivalist whose first piece of advice is hope for the best and prepare for the worst.
Are we scaring the crap out of people? Yeah.
I'm always that glass is half full kind of guy. And the more prepared you are, the less fear that you have.
And for Tim, that means more than just stockpiling supplies. It means preparing for the real danger, unprepared people.
It happens fast. Within 3 days, there's no electricity, there's no phone. It's about having food delivered. It's about having running water.
Because we're not talking about just like, oh, I don't have access to my Instagram account.
When the grid goes down, then it gets serious, and that's when panic starts to set in.
Tim practices survival skills and runs what he calls bug out evacuations with his family, like what he did for the Nat Geo show Doomsday Preppers.
Go, go, go. Get him, get him, get him.
You have a bunker. You're not going to tell us where it is.
No.
We weren't allowed to even see footage of his remote bunker.
Between here and where I want to go, I know every water location. There's a few undisclosed areas that I have big barrels that I've buried, and they have extra stuff in there.
And if you don't have the money for a full-on bunker,
you could go to the mountains and rent a storage container, $50 a month. You could put all your gear in there.
Which brings us to number two. You gotta get the gear.
This is how it all started off. Crowbar. Part crowbar, all shovel, all business. It's got 13 different tools from hammers to pickaxes.
And a bottle.
You gotta have that.
Tim has invented dozens of multi-tools, including the Tomahawk.
It's just about pounds equal pain. So the more tools I can pack into one item, the better off we are.
And then there's the adventure pod.
That is basically a tent that you can put up in the trees. We actually have a tent that goes over top of this, so then it keeps all your body heat inside.
Raise yourself up to 35 feet in the trees to stay clear of the elements, wild animals, or marauders.
This is quite relaxing.
Finally, practice the 5 C's.
I call this a get home bag.
Tim says you should have supplies in your car at all times, and his bag is well prepared.
What does the average person absolutely need?
You could break this down really simple to the 5 C's. You have to have something that can cut, all right? So that would be your knife. Now, this knife kind of does double duty because it also has another C, combustion. That would be something that starts a fire.
Our third C is cordage. It helps with building shelter, fishing, and hunting. Next,
cover, whether it's, you know, the blanket or building a lean-to with this thing.
Cover.
All right.
And our final C, container.
You've got to have something to transport water. That's your 5 C's.
5 C's.
That's it.
How to be a master of disaster is at the top of our list.